So we're going to start now looking at consumer surplus and producer surplus problems. And one of the main things that I want you to do is I want you to think about this diagram. I know I included it in the PowerPoint, and hopefully you've watched the PowerPoint already. But this is a really important visualization for what we're studying, because if you look at our red curve here, which is our demand curve, and our blue curve, which is our supply curve, one of the very first things that we're going to look at is our point of equilibrium. And that point of equilibrium actually forms this interesting rectangle. And with that rectangle, we're going to be looking at two different areas. We're going to look at the area under the rectangle, and that's going to help us a lot. But the two areas that we're specifically going to look at are going to be this area in the red, which is above the rectangle but below the line of the demand curve. For producer surplus, we're going to be looking at the area that's above the demand curve but below the area of the rectangle. So over in the orange text box at the right, you can see that I've just set up some basic steps. The first step is just to set up a spreadsheet and find the market equilibrium between the supply and the demand functions. The second thing that we're going to do is we're going to find the area of the rectangle using our x and d of x, or x and y value for the rectangle itself. That is going to allow us to multiply and find the area of the rectangle. For consumer surplus, we're going to set up the integral from 0 to the x value that we found in market equilibrium. We're going to anti-differentiate our demand function. This will give us a value, and then we're going to subtract the area of the rectangle. So look at what I'm doing essentially. I'm taking the area under the demand curve, and I'm going to subtract out the area of the rectangle. This is actually interpreted as the money that's saved by consumers when the product is sold at the market equilibrium price. The next thing we're going to look at is producer surplus. For producer surplus, we're going to use the supply function. Remember, we're trying to find the area in the blue. So what we're going to do is, again, take the area of the rectangle, but this time it's above the area that we need, and subtract from 0 to x that antiderivative of the supply function in terms of x. We're going to interpret this value as the money saved by the producer, or perhaps the extra profit, when the product is sold at the market equilibrium price.